Are we on?
Wow. What a giving person. What a giving woman. Both of them. Both Balalaika and Selena. Kudos. Just classiness all around.
Well, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, CAW fans worldwide, to Wildcats 65. I am Mr. SRH here with Zahia Morgan, whose ego just got inflated bigger than his lips.
Oh, petty, petty insults. You're just mad because I got congratulated and you didn't.
I'm not mad at all. I'm perfectly chill. I'm chill like a cucumber. But anyways, got some excellent contests for you tonight. We're starting things off with Ryan's favorite girl,
Miss Ellie Rose. I'm not saying her nickname.
I don't even remember her nickname.
I remember. I ain't saying it though. But Ellie Rose making her way down to the ring. A woman who, I'm gonna be quite honest, hasn't had a lot going for her ever since the season started. But, you know, maybe she can change that around by getting a win here in our opening contest.
Maybe so. And, by the way, Ryan, if you're watching this, we'll do our best to hype her up for you, okay?
And Eddie, if you're watching this, I want you to know this is what happens when your big mouth writes checks that your ass can't cash.
What do you mean by that?
You'll see soon enough, Mr. SRH. Oh, God.
I'm blind. I can't see. Oh.
We know who this is.
Oh, dear Jesus.
Madison Lockhart.
She came back recently after being off DCA for a little bit, right? I'm trying to refresh my memory here.
Well, last time I remember, she was taken out by one Bo Dennis, came back, destroyed Bo Dennis, and we haven't seen Bo since. And ever since then, Madison's been on a war path. And if that is the case, that's not going to bode well for anyone involved, especially Miss Sally Rose.
Well, hopefully her insurance is good. She might need a facial reassembly surgery there.
Ellie
and
taunting actually,
is probably not the smartest thing to do.
Yeah, Ellie actually proven that she has some guts trying to back away Madison, but that only gets her an exploder suplex.
And also, Madison's the kind of person that will spill your guts all over the canvas.
I wouldn't doubt it. I would not doubt it. And a backbreaker.
Ellie Rose. Definitely getting handled here. And Madison.
It's not fair. It's not fair. It's like Ellie is outmatched in almost every single way possible.
Well, at least she has her looks for now.
Yeah, we're going to see. We're going to see how long those looks last in this contest.
Oh, and another backbreaker.
Considering,
from Madison.
Hoping that Madison doesn't kick her face and her facial features right off.
Irish whip now. Off the ropes and. Oh! Missed a scoop slam attempt. Ellie Rose.
Off the ropes and. Well, she
power
tried.
Power slam.
She tried. But I don't see this going the way that Ellie wants it to.
I'm agreeing with you, and there's it's not often I do.
Oh my god, super kick.
The kick.
Might have dislocated her jaw with that one.
It's a good thing DCA has a good dental coverage, right? And now, really? Oh god, no.
Can't even afford security. Ow. What do you think? Ow. We get dental insurance?
Ow. She's gonna snap her arm in half.
Yeah, it's over. It's over.
Now, that's making very, very short work of Ellie Rose here.
That super kick to the jaw and almost snapping her arm in half with that hammerlock Fujiwara armbar. Madison, once again, like I said, is on an absolute warpath. And yes. God have mercy on anyone who steps in her way.
I don't want to be the person that steps in her way. There you see, just torquing the arm back like that. Just, no.
There was nothing Nelly could do, and
you can almost see the look of pain on Ellie's face.
Pain, anguish, heartbreak, all of it was on the face of Miss Ellie Rose, thanks to that woman, Madison Lockhart. That could be the fate of very many other women on this Wildcats roster if they step in her general direction.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Wildcat 65. And
what the hell? Oh boy!
That's Xiao.
That is Miss Yang Xiao.
Yang Xiao Long.
One half of Team RWBY, alongside her partner Blake Belladonna, which will be the team to take on the Wraith Slayers, Aubrey Williams and Mayumi Ishibashi, come
shame.
Proving ground floor.
Shame on you.
For the Wildcats Tag Team Championship.
Well, looks like we're gonna see Yang Xiaolong try her hand in some singles competition?
I believe so. I believe this is a singles match. Quite similar to what the Wraith Slayers had to go through during Revelations Week when they had to have one-on-one matches with Pirate's Life. However, they'll be taking on a different team this time. I'm going to get more familiar with Team RWBY.
To see Yang Xiaolong. That's going to take me a minute to get used to.
Just call her Yang.
As we see Yang step in the ring. Remember, she's sporting a bionic arm.
That is a robot arm, yes. After it getting sliced off by a certain someone, but that's a story for another day.
And here she is. Lethal Aubrey. And sweet. Everyone's favorite treat. It's Aubrey Williams.
Did you make that last part up?
Yes, I did.
Anyway, Aubrey Williams. One half of Rave Slayers, along with my Mimi. Current Wildcats Tag Team Champions. Also undefeated in tag team competition.
That is true. That is a true statement right there.
They came in, I think they made their debut back at the last Rumble Roses event. And ever since then, they've been pretty much dominating the Wildcats Tag Team Championship scene.
Just think, it's only a few more months left until May of 2018. We might see Rave Slayers have a year-long undefeated streak.
Could be the case. Oh. But first they have to get past Team RWBY.
We saw Yang do that wrestling power slam, followed it up with an elbow, and just going to work on Aubrey.
Aubrey started out here in the DCA as a singles competitor. As many may know, she was the protege of one Malik Brown before meeting my Mimi and her starting the tag team with her. So she's got she's got experience in singles competition as well. Off the ropes. Oh, non-Samoan drop there from Yang.
So you know a little bit of history about Team RWBY, right? What's the history of Yang Xiaolong? If you know it.
If you're talking about what wrestling company they came from, I believe her and Blake are from ACL. If you're talking about more specific, well, Yang in her own right is she's a bit of a firecracker. Also, former Lioness Tag Team. Former Lioness Tag Team Champions are Team RWBY from ACL. Like I was saying, Yang is a bit of a firecracker. I mean, she's a bit hot-headed. You know, she can get a little bit ahead of herself, but she also can work that to her advantage because it seems. Wait a second, cover here.
No.
It seems the more damage she takes, the more powerful she gets.
So essentially, she can just bide the punishment as she gets dished out, or as she gets dished to her, and bring it back to the opponent tenfold.
Exactly.
That's gonna be dangerous going into the tag team championship match.
Yeah, no kidding. Aubrey's gonna have to find a way to fight around that. And probably slamming her head.
Slam.
Yeah, probably slamming her head into the canvas isn't such a smart idea.
Oh, neither it's slapping her right across the face.
Aubrey heading up top here.
Taking flight.
Telling Yang to get back to her feet. What in the world is she out playing? Oh. Missile drop kick straight to the head.
Aubrey now. No. Reversal from Yang. And a vicious lariat.
She hit her with that robot arm, too.
And she's continuing the barrage here with some elbows.
Good damn near knocked out Aubrey with that lariat. My goodness. Especially with that arm?
No.
I mean, how is that not considered a weapon?
I don't know. I don't know. I've asked this question on many other occasions where there's... Oh, wait. Cover. One. No. I've asked this question on many other occasions where there has been virtual wrestlers with robotic arms. I don't know how they can get by using those arms.
Figure four neck lock. Here from Aubrey.
Yang gonna escape it. Snap a takedown there, and Look at this. A deep chin lock here.
With the robot. No, wait. That is not with the robot arm, my bad. I was about to say, if she used that robot arm, that was kind of cheating. Forearm.
Oh!
Holy shit!
The boot!
Good night!
One, two. Oh, no.
Oh, that was close. That was very, very close.
Aubrey's thawing off to the crowd, getting them hyped. Going to keep them excited here. And I could have been a mistake. No. Oh, what's in the back of that?
Yeah, big mo. Oh, my goodness.
Oh, wait a minute. Look at that. Schoolboy
setup. That's what I'm talking. That's what I'm talking about. And now she's all fired up. You think you have the advantage with Yang, but she just comes back even stronger.
Oof. Aubrey just tossing Yang halfway across the ring there with that toss. And
what the hell is she playing? What is she doing? Oh, wait.
Oh!
Oh, God!
Hitting a forearm off the springboard. One.
She hit off it, though.
Two.
And the answer was no. She did not.
Aubrey kicking the hamstring now.
Aubrey, I believe if she had connected a bit more precisely with that flying forearm, she might have had this match won.
Fireman's carrying to a stun gun. And if Aubrey did get more of that, I'm sure it would have been a three. Oh! Aubrey playing a methodical game here.
We ain't talking about chess, ladies and gentlemen. Not even checkers. Probably Monopoly.
Oh yeah, Monopoly can get pretty crazy. Oh, elbow to the gut there. And Aubrey back in control. What a face buster.
That's an original face buster. Nothing fancy about that. Just slamming the opponent's face in the canvas.
Dude, no. Aubrey, once again, just staying on Yang like an ugly on an ape. Head up, reversal.
Aubrey at this point really should, find a way to put this one away. What? Oh, I thought Yang was gonna go up top and I almost got very scared for a second.
Very scared or very excited? Oof! Aubrey Williams just got waffled and now Yang, oh!
Belly to belly suplex on the outside. And Yang.
No protection out there, by the way.
Oh, goodness.
And
looks like there's no protection on those ring posts. It's just pure steel. We're not talking about Zaya either.
Aubrey now, higher swept, sending Yang back in, and this could be her moment. She's heading up top.
Aubrey looking to fly.
Oh, no water in the pool.
Goodness. A dry landing for Aubrey Williams. And now, wait a minute.
With the robot punch.
With the robot arm. How is that legal? How is this legal?
Two. No!
How is she even conscious? She clocked her right in the face with her robot hand with that robot Superman punch.
Your guess is as good as mine, Zahaya, but Aubrey's still in this for the time being in Snake Eyes from Yang. Off the ropes. Oh, missed the double axe. Aubrey being smart and sliding out.
gets back in, though.
Nightmare. Now she's doing a surfboard stretch here. Yang throwing a bow to the gut.
And now, wrestling style takedown.
And a cover.
One, two.
And
go.
Yang Xiao Wang just defeated one half of the Wildcats Tag Team Champions.
I guess
with a wrestling takedown slam.
I guess that robot hand with that robot Superman punch did a lot more damage than Aubrey was letting on.
I mean, there's that. But look at it this way. Aubrey lost to a wrestling takedown slam.
Well, at the point where I think she has a concussion. I don't think she was fully aware of what she was doing when she kicked out. She probably didn't even know where she was.
That's fair.
Everything after that punch was probably out of instinct.
That's fair.
But nonetheless,
Team RWBY's got momentum going into Proving Ground.
Yeah.
Hella momentum.
Well, we've seen teams get momentum over the Rave Slayers before. That doesn't mean they are out of the contest yet. We still have some time before Proving Ground 4 and for the Rave Slayers to pick back up where they started.
There we see that Superman punch that most likely was the catalyst.
He gave her a concussion. She was knocked loopy. She needs a doctor. It was foolish of her to even kick out of this.
But it was the heart of Aubrey Williams that did the kicking out and allowed her to stay in the match as long as she did. But nevertheless, Yang Xiao Long winning one for Team RWBY.
Very impressive. Very, very impressive. Now, somebody please go check up on Aubrey. For the love of God.
Now you care about the Rave Slayers.
Oh, for the love of God.
Sucker tried to blame me, but you never paid me, never.
Oh no, you didn't.
Payback is a coming, you will be running forever.
Oh no, you didn't.
Until I get my vengeance, I will never end this mayhem.
Oh no, you didn't.
I'm a mercenary, you ain't got a prayer, you owe me.
Oh no, you didn't.
Oh no, you didn't. Oh no, you didn't. Oh no, you didn't. Oh no, you didn't. Didn't you? Oh no, you didn't pay me what you owe me. So now it's over for you.
Yo, yo, check it out.
Oh no, you didn't.
First you try to trap me, then you bust a cap in my ass.
Oh no, you didn't.
Such humiliation will bring annihilation at last.
Oh no, you did.
It will be delicious when I get vicious tomorrow.
Oh no, you did.
There's no second chances. You will do the dance of sorrow.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to DCA Wildcat 65. And here comes Elizabeth Frieza, a ZCW native, heading into her match. And once again, this is Ahia Morgan. I went to the concession stands, avoiding Elizabeth Frieza, almost like he owes her some alimony there. But nonetheless, we're going to get set with some action here. Frieza looking absolutely hyped. So does the crowd. Lights, I'm blind. Can't see. Oh, it's Maya. Maya, the, what was it, the dubstep queen or something like that? A very close personal friend of Carmen Cortez. And I thought the crowd was on their feet, but whoa. Okay, that actually looks pretty spectacular. I was gonna say, I thought the crowd was on their feet before, but now. Here comes the leader with the bomb choke up. Try to die. Bomb choke up, baby. For life. I'm sporting the jacket that you can get at DCAshop.com. Some fatal four-way action here. We got three out of the four participants. Throwing up the bones, letting people know the Bombshell Club is here. Oh my God! Sorry, I get really hyped. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm getting an updated card. This is a fatal four-way match to determine who to determine who takes on Taylor Starr at Proving Ground 4 for the Fever Championship. And I gotta say, this is a pretty stacked fatal four-way. We got Ovana, got Mercedes, we got Elizabeth Prieza, we got Maya. Holy crap, this is stacked. And I wish Ohio was here. I'm almost certain he'd mark out over some of this action. I'm hoping we get. I can't really say if I have a favorite or not to win this match. All I know is this is going to be a good. I hope it's. Ovana looking into the crowd at her fans, the DCA universe. That's probably a dumb name to call the fans, but she's looking out at the crowd, at the audience. Everybody's excited. It's fatal four-way action to determine who faces Taylor Starr. With your title, and we see Maya going after Ovana. Oof. And Frieza going after Mercedes Sanchez. And look at Maya. Deadlift gut wrench. And she ain't done. She's holding on. And Another gut wrench. Wait. Third one for safety measure. Oh. The strength of Maya doing those three consecutive gut wrenches, and Frieza and Sanchez are fighting on the outside, beating the crap out of each other, and now Frieza gets sent back in. Oh, and a very poorly connected elbow to the side of Ivana's head. Maya's down, though. Oh! Set out spinning spine buster. Mercedes going to work on Frieza. And DDT from Ivana. Trying to fight back in this. Irish whip now. Nope. Another Irish. Oh, drop kick. Maya staying on. They're trying to stay on Ivana like a bad habit now. Mercedes getting in the middle of it. Was briefly. Oh, and Mercedes gets walloped off the middle rope. Fireman's carry takedown and an elbow right to the leg of Mercedes. Frieza end up top. Oh! Backstabber to Mercedes. And a stomp right to the gut there from Maya. And wait, Frieza. Oh, God. Chicken wing lung blower there. I think that's what it is, right? Either way, it was effective, and Ivana snap suplex on the outside to Maya. Frieza trying to fight off Mercedes with those kicks, but to no avail, and monkey flip. Mercedes up top.
Oh, there you are.
Finally, you're commentating an Elizabeth Frieza match instead of avoiding her like you owe her alimony or child support.
What do you mean?
Or both.
What do you mean avoid? I haven't been avoiding her.
Every time she has a match, you're always gone.
Look, I don't know what you're talking about.
Ever since she got rid of the tight leather.
Shh.
You've been avoiding her.
Shut up.
And Toby Atomico there from Frieza.
I think that was more of a springboard blockbuster. And now Frieza
went and look at this bow and arrow. Mercedes can tap out.
Ivana and wait, who the hell? Is that Maya?
Yes, that's Maya.
Oh, God. What the? What happened?
What happened? I'll tell you what happened. A fatal four-way match to determine who faces Taylor Starr at Proving Ground 4 for the Fever title. That's what's happening right now. And Maya was named one of the people in this match. That's what happened.
Oh, yeah.
And Elizabeth Frieza was also named as one of the people, but you were avoiding her like a bad habit.
That a very, very courteous offer. Wait a second, Cobber.
One, two. Oh, Maya knocks out the ref.
God damn it.
It goes to show that we need AJ Monahan to referee all the matches.
Wait a minute. Speed kick, force two.
Frieza not going for the cover. It looks like Maya's flattened like a pancake, though.
What the hell is she doing?
Oh, did you see that toss? And a run off the top rope.
One of these lucky four women is going to have the wonderful chance to face Taylor Starr for the Celestial. No.
Fever.
It's not Fever's Championship. The Fever Championship. At Proving Ground 4, all thanks to the gracefulness and, you know, just the kind-heartedness of Miss Balalaika herself.
Oh, God. Oh, Jesus.
And people And people in the comment section and people even around this announce table want to tell me that she's not doing a good job? Are you kidding me?
I mean, look, I didn't say she wasn't doing a good job. She's doing exactly what she said she was going to. I've said this quite a bit. Doesn't mean I have to like some of the methods that she uses to enforce her.
Whatever works, Mr. SRH, whatever works.
Oh, and speaking of whatever works, you gotta think these ladies are gonna do whatever will work to win that contendership. Remember, this is Fatal 4-Way rules, so there's no disqualification. These ladies can pull out a chair or a baseball bat, anything.
Yeah, break the rules, why don't you? In fact, somebody break the rules right now, because there are none.
Oh,
God. Is that a neck breaker?
That was a neck breaker. Out of nowhere. That was like a ricochet-styled neck breaker there.
It had to be from somewhere. And that's just humiliating. Oh, wait. Ovana looking for it. Perfect fit.
Booty. Razor, wait, cover. Razor. One.
Cover.
Two.
No.
Senton. Demaya. And now the cover. One.
What?
Two.
Two.
And Ovana.
Got her. Ovana is going to Proving Ground 4 to take on Taylor Starr for the Fever Championship.
What an electrifying contest here it was. Some fast-paced back and forth action, and then we see the ref getting knocked out because he's not AJ Monahan. Look at that.
All four women willing to risk it all to at least get a chance at capturing that Fever's championship. And it just turned out for Ovana to be at the right place at the right time to get the victory.
Exactly. We thought that Riza was going to win it just briefly, but no. And then it was a senton to put the final nail in the coffin.
A little shout out to Mr. Dick Togo himself with that senton.
And look at that. I mean, just look. Right in front of Frieza and Mercedes.
For Ovana, a title match. For Elizabeth, no
tight, no tight leather.
Okay. I was going to say no win. But I guess that too. Ovana facing Taylor Starr at Proving Ground 4.
Thank you.
Oh. Some very choice words from Miss Taylor Starr, our Fever's champion.
Very choice and very fighting words there.
Well, Ovana's going to have to bring the fight to Taylor Starr if she's going to have any chance of taking that title away from her.
Well, if history's any indication, Ovana has proven that she can bring the fight to damn near anyone. But yeah, I guess where it matters the most, she's gonna have to definitely bring it. I think this is our main event for the evening.
And correct me if I'm wrong, but this is the other fatal four-way match, am I right?
Nope, not main event, my bad.
So yes, I was right. This is the other one, and this one will determine who will be put into the Wildcats Championship match between Sakura Hagiwara and Selena Zeda come Proving Ground 4. And here's a woman who was very lucky to be in this contest, all because of the request of Selena herself.
I mean, look, if anyone deserves a shot in that match, it's definitely Cleopatra.
Not after her unsolicited attack on one Selena herself. She is very, very lucky.
You know what? Hold on. Selena attacked a good portion of the Wildcats roster just to get a title shot.
Hold that thought, Mr. SRH. There's no way. Oh my goodness.
Well, be
straight from the UCWL women's roster, it's Miss Bindi Irwin herself.
Huh. We haven't seen her in a DCA associated ring since Queens of Wrestling.
Yeah, I don't think since the Queens of Wrestling tournament. Bindi Irwin last season was considered the ultimate underdog, not getting through most of the year, not getting a win until the UCWL Queens of Wrestling qualifying tournament,
where she
defeated Quiet of all people, and then in the first round of the Queens of Wrestling tournament, she defeated Captain Marvel.
I mean, it's going to be interesting to see
what the hell? Oh my god! Oh my god! Ah! One half! Mr. SRH, do you know who this is?
I have a feeling you're gonna tell me.
One half of Pirate's Life, that is Megan Van Horn! And we have a
haven't seen her since Revelation.
She looks a little different, though.
Straight off her voyage through the Pacific Ocean with Mari.
Wait a minute, what? Did you guys say... Am I saying that right? Pacific Ocean.
Yes, Pacific Ocean.
Okay. All right.
Well, apparently, yeah, the Pacific Ocean. But nonetheless, Bacon Van Horn making a very surprise return here to Wildcats.
No way.
There's no way.
Oh.
Oh my God. Mr. SRH.
Is she familiar to you?
She's back. Rachel fucking Diaz.
And I can tell by how wide your eyes are, that's a good thing, right?
This woman hasn't been seen here in DCA for how long has it been?
You'd probably know. Remember, I'm still technically new here.
One of Amber's students, along with Madison Lockhart and in a way Bindi Irwin as well. Last time we saw her was at Queens of Wrestling 2 when she faced off against Pyra.
Well, that's probably why we haven't seen her in that long.
Nonetheless, Rachel Diaz making her return to DCA.
Jesus.
Just think, one of these four women will be added to the Wildcats title match at Proving Ground 4, where they will face both Selena Zeda and the current Wildcats champion, Sakura Hagiwara.
Bendy, Juan Pano Uranagi.
And we can all thank Miss Balalaika and the temptress herself, Selena Zeda, for this generous, generous offer.
Well, I'll give you
generous.
You know, I'm trying to give credit where credit's due, and you're interrupting me. I will give the devil its due and say yes, these are some excellent matches that Balalaika has orchestrated, however you want to word it, for the DCA audience. I will give her all the credit in the world.
How dare you call her a devil? This woman has been
God. Did you see that German suplex from Cleopatra?
That was a pretty impressive German suplex.
And
Hurricanrana. When Rachel sends Bindi to the outside.
Imagine, if you will. Imagine one of Amber Stevens' students picking up a win and heading into, what is it, the Wildcats title match.
Yes.
I mean, imagine, because technically the AMS Academy has a 50% chance here.
Well, considering we haven't seen Amber in quite a while, hopefully she'd be looking on somewhere. Probably a little bit proud of her two students right now.
Oh.
Have a big opportunity ahead of them. You got two students trained by Amber Stevens, Megan Van Horn, who is very underrated in my opinion, and a woman who, in my honest to God opinion, doesn't even deserve the shot, but thanks to the very, very forgiving...
Hold on. Explain this. How does she not, considering everything that she has done in her years?
Look, all right.
You can tell she attacked Selena Zeda. You know how many people Selena Zeda attacked just to get a title shot as well?
Last time I checked, none of those people had a shot for the Wildcats Championship. She does.
And exactly how is that any different?
Look, Mr. SRH, it's a what have you done for me lately around here. And lately, she has not won a lot of matches here. Unlike Selena, who is, let me spell it out for you, big money talent.
You know, I feel like there is a cat that dies every time you say that. And now an Irish whip setting Cleopatra to the outside. Rachel gonna try to go to work, and Indy's just circling around here. And oh! Cover.
You know, it's in matches like this, it's no wonder Miss Balalaika recruited her, because she sees the talent in her just as much as I do.
You know, I'm not touching that one. I've already said my piece on the matter. Oh! God! And good Rachel night. Diaz throwing Cleopatra onto the apron corner there. That's a straight up steel. That's a steel bar there.
Yeah, if this beating continues, Cleopatra might not have to worry about the Wildcats Championship. She should be more worried about leaving here with her career still intact.
At the very same time, shouldn't you be kind of fearing a little bit if someone like Rachel Diaz wins? And goes on to take on Selena and Sakura.
I mean, we're talking about a woman who is quite possibly just as dangerous, if not more so, than Madison Lockhart. So, I'd be pretty worried.
I mean, this is a direct disciple of Amber Stevens.
Oh God, what a kick! Cleo, but what the
hand
world?
Handspring into a moonsault.
Okay, now that was just showing off.
Hey, you know what? Sometimes showing off can work. And now, backbreaker, and Rachel tosses her off to the side.
Cover. Gracious.
One, two, no. I see. Part of why, to your statement earlier, part of why Amber Stevens hasn't really been seen is I heard she's training new people. Of course, it's just a rumor. Oh,
I think it's something entirely different, but I'll just save that for another day.
Oh, and once again, the referee gets abused.
God damn it.
Once again, if this was AJ Monahan, he wouldn't take that crap.
You just got kicked in the back, man. Get the hell up and do your
DDT
job.
DDT from Megan and...
There goes Bindi.
Could you imagine, real quick, if Megan wins for Pirate Life? Could you imagine that?
I could imagine it.
I mean, she could.
I think I'd see a very...
I think there'd be a drunken bar fight at the end of the night. And look
at
this!
Sharpshooter! Scorpion Deathlock!
I'm sorry, Scorpion Deathlock!
Oh, no! Are you kidding?
Cleo just stole this one!
No, I think I need a replay, because I'm pretty sure Bindi broke up that submission.
Well, I mean, it only really counts as a breakup if Cleo isn't able to keep the hold on.
I want a replay.
Okay, we're seeing a replay right here.
Call flag on that play.
See Bindi taking flight to Megan and trying to go for a cover, winning one for the AMS Academy. Only gets not even a two count. Now look at that. Rachel Diaz in her return, tossing Cleopatra off to the side like a sack of potatoes.
Like a sack of something, that's for sure.
But look, and at then this. Here.
Fourth in death lock.
Riddle Let's me take this. A look. Riddle me that.
Locked in. Middle of a ring. Here comes Bindi.
And Bindi. A little.
God damn it. Yeah.
Too close, but, you know. Being too close and not being effective are different things.
Congrats, Julio. You got your big opportunity. But can't you get past both Sakura and Selena come Proving Ground 4? My chances say no.
That was a really great fail four-way match. Cleopatra is now the third lady in that Wildcats title match at Proving Ground 4.
By the gracefulness of Selena herself.
Yeah, give no credit to Cleopatra for winning the match.
By the gracefulness, whatever. We gotta run down this card real quick, Mr. SRA.
We got a stacked card for Proving Ground 4. I mean, my God, it's stacked.
And we're going to start off this stack card with the DCA Wildcats Tag Team Championships as Team RWBY. Blake Belladonna and Yang Xiaolong take on the current Wildcats Tag Team Champions, Aubrey Williams and Mai Mimi Ishibashi.
Shame.
Shut up. Then we have the Rising Star title as the challenger, Trish, takes on the queen of ultra violence herself, Lacey Adams.
And then we have AJ Young taking on Smokey in a match that Smokey has never, ever lost in a steel cage match. This one is probably going to be a barn burner there.
Also coming up at Proving Ground 4, it's the DCA Fever Championship match. As Ovana, the winner of our first Fatal 4-Way match, will take on the current champion, Taylor Starr. Can Ovana finally fulfill her promise as the Cinderella Sensation?
Well, maybe. But speaking of sensations, there's no bigger sensation than the Battle of the Queens. Carmen Cortez will take on Naughty for the Queens of Wrestling Championship.
An instant classic that will be. And also, you want to talk about classics? This one should be a doozy because the DCA World Champion, Takeru, defends his championship for the first time against the knockout man himself, Calvin Richardson.
And then, just recently changed, it is a triple threat match for the DCA Wildcats Championship. We got Sakura Hagiwara, Selena Vega, and Cleopatra Sphinx. Oh, man. Oh, man.
All of that and more coming soon to Proving Ground 4, coming in just a few weeks. Going to be live from Baltimore, Maryland.
The hometown of Eddie Mack.
Yeah.
But
not
that's later.
Tonight.
That's later. Right now, we got some main event action for you. And lights are out again. Here she
Shut
comes.
Your mouth, Mr. SRH. It is time for you and for everyone here in the Wildcats Arena to bow down to your temptress. The gatekeeper herself, and quite possibly your future Wildcats champion, Selena Zeda.
You done? Are you done? Straight up interrupting me. Just undercut me right then and there.
I'll never be done, but you can speak.
Thank you. Thank you very much for allowing me to do my job. Anyways, Selena Zeda. Selena Zeda making a challenge to pretty much the entirety of the DCA fans and to our broadcast colleagues who are not here, saying that she can prove that she is more than main event caliber here in DCA.
I don't think she's challenging anyone. I think it's all of you who is challenging her, and it is her in response proving you all wrong.
I mean, that's still her challenge. She's straight up saying she is going to. I mean, that's kind of her stating a challenge. Kind of the definition of stating a challenge.
Whoa! Isn't this a surprise? That's ninja.
That's
Jade fucking Storm.
We haven't seen Jade Storm in a little bit, haven't we?
Pretty sure she's been here and there.
I mean, it's been a cup of coffee since we've seen her, though. Or so it feels.
Well,
by
she's
the
in
way, a hell of an opponent for Selena.
Yeah, Jade Storm. I have pretty much known this woman since Sudden Impact. If there's anyone who is hungry and who wants, you know, who deserves an opportunity like this, it's definitely her.
The bell rings and you see an intense stare down between the two.
However, I might feel like she might have bitten off a little bit more than she could chew in this one.
Well, we're gonna find out soon enough. Calling elbow tie up, followed with an arm wrench there and supplying the pressure here. Oof. And now contorting the arm a bit more here. But Jade, armbar.
We do our armbar from Jade Storm and gets out of it just Selena Zeda. And look at the confidence just pouring out of every sweat drop of Selena Zeda.
I mean, we can call it confidence, we can call it cockiness. either or.
And Selena's... Hey, you can call it whatever you want. Just don't forget to call her the Temptress, the Gatekeeper, and possible Wildcats Champion.
Yeah, I'm not going to call it any of this sense. We see Jay Storm getting out of that predicament with a head scissors hold, and now she has a side headlock. Oh. Rolls out side headlock, and now.
Off the ropes. Whoa. Selena stopping herself, saying, no, 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 not today. We play by my rules. You're in my main event.
Selena Zeda is going to have to do a little less taunting and a little more wrestling.
Look at this. Both women trying to go for knees, but neither one can get a knee. There's a chop.
Irish whip. Like leapfrog. Oh.
Miss.
Oh.
Oh, goodness. Oh, my God.
That vicious super kick that Selena Zeda is known for doing. Now a knee right to the nog of Jade Storm.
Like I said, I like Jade. I see everything in this woman. She has all the potential in the world to be a future Wildcats champion.
Huge scoop and a slam ball with a cover one. No.
However, she's going up against a woman who is determined. It is just a bit, in my mind, just a bit more hungrier than she is at the moment.
Duck. Oh! Ooh, ooh, ooh.
As she just keeps cutting her off with these super kicks. And those kicks aren't doing any favors for Miss Jade Storm.
And, wait, Jade Storm, neck breaker. Now the cover.
Hooks the leg.
Be it. No. Now chop, forearm, roundhouse, or spin kick.
Roll butt.
Oh.
Float over suplex.
One. No.
It'll take a lot more to put down the Temptress, I know that for sure. After what we've seen for her over the past few weeks.
I mean, yeah, if you're any other person other than Balalaika, it's going to take a lot more than that to make Selena Zeda lay down there.
What are you saying, Mr. SRH? You want to elaborate on that?
I was just saying Selena Zeda is a glorified guard dog for Balalaika.
She is not a guard dog, all right? She is a gatekeeper. She is a
soldier.
She is...
Ball she is like a five-letter word for a female dog, that's for darn sure.
How dare you? You are no different from all the... You are no different from NTB. You are no different from Eddie Mac. Just all...
Hey. You want to know the difference? I'm here, and I actually acknowledge that Balalaika did some good. There's the difference there. That doesn't mean I have to like the tactics... of Selena Zeda, or the tactics of Balalaika.
You're going to undermine her best talent? You're going to undermine her best signee?
One. Two. No. Jay Storm kicks out.
This woman is more than a guard dog. All right? She is a legitimate athlete. She's a legitimate contender for the Wildcats Championship.
Legitimate.
And she's the real athlete.
Legitimate, my left butt cheek. She got that title shot from attacking everybody in sight. That's the truth.
She got there by doing whatever it takes to get there,
and
all right?
You know what? If she had a couple matches prior to getting that shot...
You mean her match with Lightning? You know, the supposed greatest of all time in the main event?
Yeah, she got that title shot before. She got that title shot way before that match, Mrs. Aya.
What does that have to do with anything?
It has everything to do with everything. If she did that match with Lightning prior, then yes, I can see why she would deserve
it. It doesn't matter. She won the match. Why are you complaining?
I'm complaining because it still boggles my mind how you can say that Cleopatra does not deserve to be anywhere near a title picture.
It's just like you said, what matches has she won lately?
And it's like you said, she did what she had to do, right, Zahaya?
She didn't do anything.
She did what she had to do. She attacked Selena Zeda. Last week, she attacked Selena Zeda. This week, she won that fatal four-way match.
This title match, if it weren't for Selena herself, you know it, I know it, and Cleopatra knows it.
No, Jade Storm not getting the pin. And you know what? Your logic still is it's a backstabber. 1, 2. No. And look, your logic can still apply to Cleopatra that you use for Selena Zeta. No matter how you flip the coin, no matter what you say, it still applies.
Last time I checked, she defeated Suzumi, and she defeated Lightning. She took out Miyako, and she took out Lucinda. So I'm pretty sure that is more.
And she also took out the ref earlier.
In order to prove herself,
she also took out the ref earlier. Jade had the match won. This match should have been over with Jade getting her hand raised. So what about that, Zahaya?
What's wrong with playing smart, Mr. SRH?
I don't know. You have an issue with it when it's everybody but Selena Zeta doing it. So I'm asking you.
Look, clearly that was an accident.
One.
She was.
Two. No. Only
clearly it was an accident. She didn't mean to hit the ref. You're just making excuses at this point.
I'm just going as I see it.
And now, Jade. Nope. Punch the midsection.
Couple chops. Oh. And gets sent out of the ring the hard way.
Jade Storm.
Fired up off the ropes.
To go flying!
Ooh, ooh.
Dear Lord!
A rope-assisted Atomico there. The crowd's on their feet. Jade Storm. Right.
Whoa!
Up the springboard with Arana. 1, 2. No. Very close count there.
Jade Storm doing very well so far.
Oh. And look at this. That's a Indian deathlock if memory serves correct, isn't it? No.
That it is.
Jade Storm definitely pulling out some moves here. Oh, reversal there from Zeta, and now
so quick on her feet. You know, that's a sign of a true great champion. Quick on her feet.
She was on her back when she was quick that time.
Like a fucking cat. So graceful.
I don't know about cats being graceful, but yeah, Selena Zeta did get quick with that reversal. I'll give you that.
Living blow to the back there from Jade.
Oh! Haluva kick. 1, 2. No.
Also known as that. Hell of a kick.
And Jade, double
moves. Meteora!
Also known as the Meteora.
God, tried to go for the headbutt, didn't get it. And now Selena, with the knee straight to the back.
And now Selena.
Looked
like she was going for a kick, but gets clotheslined out of the ring. Yeah. What's Jay doing?
Probably nothing. Nothing smart. Oh God! Oh God!
Oh, missed no, she missed. Line.
Oh. Oh God!
Taking her leg out of the leg there and continuing to taunt to the crowd.
Actually, I believe she kicked her shin out of her leg.
Point being, she got hurt. That's my main point. Selena Zeta setting Jay Storm back in, now going right back on her. Oh,
not showing any mercy to the young rookie here.
Young rook, really?
What?
Young rook, you surprised me.
You know, she was in the Rising Star division the last season. Rolling elbow.
Jade Storm taking it to the other young rookie.
Not a rookie.
Technically.
Nope.
Technically, she is.
Not even.
Oh!
Damn! There is a difference to being new to a company and being new to wrestling in general.
And.
Last time I checked, Selena had a chance at the having a chance at the DCA roster 2 years ago, but they passed her up.
Selena now stalking Jade Storm here. And Northern Lights there. One.
What a bridge.
Two.
You see that bridge? London Bridge has nothing on it.
What's Selena getting ready to do?
Oh, here it comes! No! Wait! Oh. Missed! Bring the clothesline!
And a splash! Didn't land all of it, it looked like, but maybe enough. And a back suplex driver. Jade Storm, Irish whip. And.
Wilbur! Suplex!
Cover. One. Two. No. Jade Storm definitely showing she can hang. Oh, missed the clothesline.
Okay.
Oh! One, two, no. Selena, version. Oh, God. Jesus. And kick. A super kick.
Right. That's it. A valiant effort, but this one is over. No, it is not.
So you're going to talk about not giving competitors a chance here. You're just undermining Jade Storm's ability. Jesus!
Oh, been undermining her.
One, two, no. I mean, you just straight up assumed that the match was over.
Look, that kick to the back of the head looked very vicious, okay? I wouldn't be surprised if anyone got knocked out from that.
And now Selena lifting Jay Storm to the top. Kick for a trouble in. Body splash. Cross body off the top. And Jade Storm stalking. What's she doing here? Oh, oh, gets clothesline.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is what we call a receipt. And we call that a knee drop.
We call that a roll up.
Actually gets called a Hurricane Rana.
You know, Exploder!
Oh, wait. Selena. Oh, this could not be good. She could be in trouble. Oh, and now look at that. Jade doing the smart thing here. But the fight of a champion, the heart of a champion that Selena Zeda has with inside herself is just beyond words at this point.
Selena Zeda miss heart of the champion got dumped to the outside. Oh!
Okay. Well then.
Just got dumped on her head as well.
Yeah, that she did.
It's Selena Zeda shrugging it off. And yeah, we don't know the extent of. Oh!
Now it!
Elizabeth Killer!
No.
Elizabeth Killer, one!
That flip.
Two! No!
Pulling blood to the back. Pump the belt.
Go.
And crucifix
pin. One. Two. No.
It looked like Jade had the power of God on her side that time.
Back suplex.
Right on her head.
One. Two. No. And now Jade Storm trying to rally up the crowd again here. And oh, gets elbowed for her troubles. And now Selena just placing.
Striking away.
Oh, and again Selena gets dumped on her head. What's Jade Storm doing? Oh
my God! Oh goodness! All right, that wasn't. I don't think that was the smartest decision.
No, not at all. That elbow sending, Selena Zeda head first into the steps. It looked in. Oh! And what? Taking the head first. Oh.
I think Selena needs to get her in the ring and pin her, because I don't think Jade's even conscious.
You know, I don't agree with you a lot, but yes, I agree with you.
Not going for the cover. She could be setting her up for the final judgment. Here it comes! No!
Codebreaker!
What? Where did that come from?
One. Two. No.
My goodness, how close was that?
That was like a hair strands close. That's how close it was. And Selena Zeda still in this. Oh. Elbow to the knee. Irish whip now.
Oh, bang! Bang!
A spinning kick combos. And oh, arm drag reversal.
Picks her up. No, leg sweep. Picks her up. No,
leg sweep.
Picks her up. No,
leg sweep. Picks her up. No. Uppercuts.
We're doing leg sweeps all day.
What the heck?
What the hell was that?
This is what we call in the business. a whirly dropkick.
Bird. Lex Luthor.
The whirly bird special. There you go. And now.
Danny Switch Godbuster.
God. See the impact of that too. Knees.
Oh.
Back foot. Knees.
Oh.
Damn knees. Into the gut of Jade Storm. Now she's stomping on the ground, demanding that Jade Storm gets up.
Here it comes. Oh. No.
Clothesline.
Clothesline.
Storm now on the top, measuring her lady. And, oh, crossbody with the pin.
One, two, no. Jade came so close to getting an upset victory of a lifetime. Jawbreaker.
Receipt.
Want cash back with that?
And the, no. Reversal.
Fireman's carry.
Fire purse's carry.
That'd
be a low PC. Throwing them bows to the side of that.
Don't you do that. No more kick. Oh my goodness!
Too close to the ropes, though.
Jade, that was a rookie mistake.
That super kick was shades of her hero, Amber Stevens.
She could have had it there. She could have had it. Cost herself that one. No. Forearm. Into the corner. Oh, Luba kick!
Jeez. And continuing the assault here. Oh, God!
Jay, this could be her chance. This could be her opportunity.
Irish whip. Duck.
Whoa! Oh. What do we call
lucha
that?
Style, a lucha style Rana there. Codebreaker!
Codebreaker! Oh, but James! Jade, she can't capitalize!
There were a couple of flapjacks there.
Come on,
and now,
Jade!
One. Two. No.
Ah!
They were both as flat as hotcakes, and yet.
I commend Jade for her effort, but I think it's got to come to a point where she's got to realize that maybe it's just not the right time for her to be going up against a woman like Selena Zeda.
Wait a second. You were just cheering on. Oh, God! You were just cheering on Jade. Like, literally 30 seconds ago.
What you're talking
about?
You said,
come on, Jade.
No recollection of that whatsoever. Oh, no.
Of course, you try to hide when
you
get called out.
Looking for the super kick.
No super kick. Oh, final judgment. One.
Good night.
Two.
Goodbye. And see you later.
What a hell of a match.
What a main event.
There's been many close calls throughout this entire match. Jade Storm could have potentially have knocked out Selena Zeda in the early goings.
Shoulda, woulda, don't
matter. Are you
saying
she should have knocked Selena Zeda out? You're actually saying that.
I'm saying that all those things were possibilities. All those things were all up in the air. But what isn't up in the air, what isn't a possibility, is the fact that Selena Zeda is still your winner, is still going to Proving Ground 4, and is still possibly your new Wildcats champion.
Well, if Selena hits the final judgment at Proving Ground, yeah, she will be the new Wildcats champion. I mean, no one's gotten up after she hit that on something. Oh, history is technically on Selena Zeta's side. Selena now is going to take her win, possibly to the back.
And if either Sakura or Cleopatra, wait a minute. Oh no. Speaking of Sakura. That is definitely her music, but where is she? Selena looking out for Sakura. Looking towards the ramp. Where the hell is she?
That is a good question. Oh, wait a minute!
Is that Sakura? It's Cleopatra! Are you freaking kidding me again with this? After what Balalaika and Selena did for me, this is how you repay them.
This is
classy. This is real smart from Cleopatra.
Actually, it is. If you really think about it, it's called taking out the competition.
It's called being a sore sport.
It's called, you would have applauded Selena Zeta for doing the same thing.
Yeah, because Cleopatra would have deserved it after what she did last time. This is just assault.
If Selena did this to Sakura, you would be cheering her on. Oh! The quicksand driver. And once again, Cleopatra getting the best of Selena Zeta. And yes, I'm gonna acknowledge this. It was from behind. But come Proving Ground 4, there is gonna be no from behind or underhanded tactics. Everything is legal there. And we could be looking at the next Wildcats champion. The one championship that Cleopatra has never held.